I was going to Reno to do a couple shows. I did two shows opening up for Kenny G. That's exactly how I felt about it. And he was a dick. I thought he was going to be a nice man because he plays puss music. I thought that was a rule. It's not. I was looking forward to it too. I was going to walk up and be all, "What up, G?" Couldn't. So I got out on stage and I said to the crowd, "Are you ready to rock? Then you're at the wrong show. I'm the only part of the show with words in it. After me, it's like 2 hours of staring at a perm in an elevator with a headache. I do weird shows all the time. Like I did a show for Pepsi Cola for their staff, and I thought it was gonna be cool, but right before I got on stage, this big shot Pepsi executive dick pulled me off to the side and he goes, "Hey, listen up, little fella. You're not allowed to say anything about Coke." So I got on stage, I said, "Hi everyone, I'm Dan, and I just left my apartment where I was snorting lines of Pepsi." I did this other show for the California Highway Patrol, and I started off with, "Hello everyone, raise your hand if you haven't already seen me pee in a cup." They didn't actually pay me in money, they paid me in DUI gift certificates. And I got to meet Ponch and John. Three people. They have this clinic in California. It's a clinic for people with bad breath. Wouldn't it suck to work at the front desk of that clinic? You know what I mean? You got fools walking in going, "Hi, how you doing?" "God damn, I know why you're here. Passion of the Christ, man. Write your name on a piece of paper and throw it to me." Smell. No way. I grew up in the small town of Pacifica, California, which is right next to the ocean. And I never learned how to surf because of one man. His name is Steven Spielberg. That's right, everybody. Et scared the shit out of me. That was a callback to the first comic. When I saw Jaws, I was like 5 years old and it ruined my childhood. I couldn't do anything in the water, and that's the coolest thing to do in Pacifica. The town's called Pacifica. And I wouldn't go in the water. I wouldn't even go in a lake. I wouldn't go in a pool because I was freaked out, convinced that there's a maniac out there raising sharks that are immune to chlorine and angered by urine. The more scared I get, the more in danger I am, and I can't have that. So I moved to LA. When I was looking for a place in LA, I didn't know the area at all. So I had to base my entire search on avoiding parts of town that Dr. Dre throws shouts out to. That was my system. Figure I can't move to Inglewood. I hear they're always up to no good. It's a word on the strizzy. I was doing a show a little while ago where there was a guy who was on stage with me. He's like standing off to my left. And I'm talking and going through the jokes and stuff, and the guy's over there interpreting all of my words into sign language. Yeah, because I guess there were deaf people or gang members there or some shit. Not sure. Cincinnati. I looked over to the guy, right? I figured I'd wave to him. And he threw me a dirty look. And I started thinking, maybe the guy isn't interpreting what I'm saying. He could be sitting over there talking shit about me to the deaf people. Having his own little deaf comedy jam or some shit. I think he was. I think he was over there going, "Okay, folks, I'll tell you what. This guy ain't all that funny. Okay, this guy sucks. Let me tell you that right now. This guy's a jerk off. Get him out of here. I'm way funnier than this fool. Listen, I got a joke for you. Two Jews walk into a bar, right? And they all went breakdancing. With Sammy Sosa. All right, that's the end of that joke. Sorry.